Renal humeral joint is having three capsules. One is the superior capsule, one is the inferior capsule, and one is the posterior capsule. Superior capsule, how to palpate? Just hold the head of the humerus, take your thumb over the head of the humerus and press. This is the superior renal humeral capsule. How to palpate the inferior renal humeral capsule? Just take the hand like this position. From the below the pectoralis major, if you just push, that is the inferior renal humeral capsule. And how to palpate the posterior renal humeral capsule? Just take the hand to the opposite side of the shoulder. In this position, just push your thumb. This is the inferior renal humeral capsule. Most of the conditions of adhesive capsulitis, এই তিনটে ক্যাপসুল কিন্তু প্রচন্ড পরিমাণে টাইট হয়ে যায়। That's the time we need to stretch the three capsule. First, we'll start stretching the inferior renal humeral capsule. Now, how I will stretch the inferior renal humeral capsule? First, before doing any of the stretch, you need to just maintain the stretching position. That is for the capsular passive movement. For the capsular passive movement, first make the hand in the position of R1 level, meaning resistance level 1, and try to stretch for 5 to 10 times. This is just for the general capsular stretch. After doing this general capsular stretch, we'll first focus for the inferior capsule. What you will do, just go for the abduction of the arm at the level of the R1 and just stable and try to go for the stable of the arm, because patient cannot go beyond of that. You can sit or you can stand. In the sitting position, what you will do, raise the patient's arm over your elbow, keep the two finger over here where we palpated the inferior renal humeral capsule. Take your another hand and go for the stability of the over the pectoralis major muscle. Using your right hand, just stable, and using the left hand, try to stretch. If you just hold this position, this is what is the inferior renal humeral capsular stretch. The time you will stretch, hold it for the 15 seconds and repeat it for the 7 to 10 times, depends on the patient's condition. If the pain aggravates, just release it. Just repeat it for the 3 to 5 times. This is for the inferior glenohumeral stretch. The time we'll go for the posterior glenohumeral stretch. The posterior glenohumeral capsule, it is present on the posterior aspect of the glenohumeral joint. For that, what you will do, you will just take the patient's hand and try to touch to the opposite side of the shoulder. Just take your left hand, try to stabilize the scapula. The reason why you are stabilizing the scapula is the time the capsule where it is attached to the glenoidal cavity and the head of the humerus, the time you will stabilize the scapula will not move. Now, using your opposite hand, just poke inside the inferior fiber of the deltoid posterior fiber, inside of the interior of the posterior deltoid fiber, and try to stretch. Using the left hand, you are stabilizing the scapula. Using the right hand, where you poke inferior fiber of the deltoid, the posterior fiber of the deltoid, and stretch. This is for the posterior glenohumeral capsular stretch. For the anterior glenohumeral capsular stretch, what we will do, just be in a standing position for the 10 degrees of abduction and just go with the pronation of the forearm. In this position, just rest it, hold your one hand over the head of the humerus. You can hold in this position also, or you can hold in this position also. Using your opposite hand over the pectoralis muscles, just stable the pectoralis and try to go for a stretch for the anterior glenohumeral capsule. hold it for 15 seconds, release, and again repeat it for the 7 times.